Now, I know what you're thinking. What does this phrase actually mean? Quite a bit, actually, because that saying provides the key to remembering an important math concept, the order of operations. The order of operations is one of the more critical mathematical concepts you'll learn because it dictates how we calculate problems. It gives us a template so that everyone solves math problems the same way. Let's start off with a simple question. What is an operation? An operation is a mathematical action. Addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, and calculating the root are all examples of a mathematical operation. Let's take a look at this problem. Looks easy, right? Well, it wouldn't be so easy if we didn't understand the order in which the math operation occurs. If we didn't have rules to determine what calculations we should make first, we'd come up with different answers. Should you start by subtracting 4 minus 6 and then multiplying by 7? No. The order of operations tells us how to solve a math problem. And this brings us back to Aunt Sally. Operations have a specific order, and this is what Please Excuse My Dear Aunt Sally helps us to understand. It's an acronym, P-E-M-D-A-S, or PEMDAS, that tells us in which order we should solve a mathematical problem. So first is please, which stands for parentheses, so we solve everything inside of the parentheses first. Then E, excuse, which is for exponents. We solve that after we solve everything in a parentheses. Multiplication, which is the my, and this happens from left to right. And then division, which is the dear, which also happens left to right. And then we have addition and subtraction, which also happens from left to right. And this is Aunt and Sally. Okay, so now that we know the order of operations, let's apply it to our problem that we have here and solve. So if Let's kind of go down our list. We don't have parentheses and we don't have exponents, but we do have multiplication. So we do that before we do any addition and subtraction. So let's go ahead and multiply 7 times 4. That gives us 28. And now we're subtracting 6, which gives us 22. Now let's look at another problem. Without the operations, you could calculate this as 7 plus 7, which is equal to 14, times 3, which is equal to 42. And this would be wrong. Remember, you multiply before you add. Therefore, the equation should look like this. So when we do problems like this, we can use parentheses to group together our numbers that are going to take place first. So in this case, it's 7 times 3. And when we do that, we get 21 and we have plus 7 left over. When we add those together, we get 28. And that's our answer. Let's look at some more complex problems. The order of operations dictates how to solve this problem. Remember, you multiply exponents first. Here's the wrong way to solve the problem. Why is that wrong? Because you violated the order of operations. You do not multiply first. You perform an operation on the exponent first. This is how it should be done. See, solving the equation in the right order provides the correct answer. Let's try out one more problem. This one is a little bit more challenging, but it perfectly illustrates the order of operations. Remember the order. What do we do first? The number inside the parentheses. So 8 times 6 is equal to 48. Then we subtract 15, and that gives us 33. Here's how the problem looks now. So our next step is multiplication and division. So let's perform all of our multiplication and division problems and then see what we have left. Now we finish with addition and subtraction. So here's what we have. And our answer is 37. There is an exception. If an equation only has one expression, you don't have to follow the order of operations. Here are some examples of single expressions. 10 plus 10. Well, there are no other operations, so you just know to go ahead and add them together and you get 20. Same thing with subtraction, multiplication, or division. All of those are single expressions. All right, guys, that's our video over the order of operations. I hope that this was helpful. See you guys next time.